right, so I got sent a link to a movie to watch this week. Now, the first thing you have to understand is this is a very Korean, culturally influenced American movie. Because it's got Brandon Lee from Mad TV. You remember him? Mm-hmm. That dude was freaking funny. He's in this movie.
Very funny.
Very funny. So it's called The Wedding Palace. And it's called The Wedding Palace because it involves this guy and his parents who own The Wedding Palace, which is like a wedding planning service. So it starts out with the traditional Korean family thing with the babies picking an item and that determines their future. He picks a maxi pad out of a purse. And so everyone thinks he's now got the family curse, and if he's not married by 30, he's going to die. So switch to the future where his parents are trying to set him up with someone. She ends up running off with the cake guy, which is important to realize for later on in the movie. So he just kind of tunes out. Turns out he works for a maxi pad promoter. His whole job is to advertise maxi pads. So he goes to Korea and meets this girl that works at the same business, and they start falling in love, and he has to come back to America, and they have this whole online relationship. And right before he turns 30, he decides to propose to her. I know this is called spoilers, but the funniest thing about this girl, I'm just going to tell you now, she's like 2.5 feet high, but no one knows that because they've only seen her sitting down. So when he finally meets her off the plane, she's like 2.5 feet high, and he freaks out because every time he's seen her, she's been sitting down. So he thought she was normal sized. Well, when he takes her to go meet the family for the first time, he's trying to hold her in place so no one like sees she's short. Well, when she gets up, the family freaks out. The grandparents have a heart attack. They're screaming, curse this, curse that. Things go downhill. The crazy lady with the bakery guy comes back later. And, you know, it's got the feel-good thing. However, this is a strong Korean culture movie. If you don't really get Korean culture or the whole family values or things like that, you would be totally lost.
I've obviously missed out on Korean culture, right? Maxi pads, the curse.
Yeah, the whole curse of family things and the arranged marriages and the way parents are and the way they expect their kids. Like, there's a sequence where he's like, fine, find me a date. Well, it's this kind of skit sequence where it's like a game show called The Wedding Palace, and all the Asian ladies come out, talk about all the things they do, and they're like, you made B's in school, no, you're out, stuff like that. You really got to understand that culture, and I understand most of it. Some of these things I didn't get because it's filmed with that style. It's got really weird things that you don't see Americans do, so you're like, is this a real game show? Is this in his mind? Is something going on? I'm confused. We find ourselves to find out a lot during the movie. However, it was freaking hilarious. It was well written. It's made for an English market, so I'm not quite sure how it's going to go as opposed to Sake Bomb, which really just went for any culture. You got to understand the specific culture in this one. But when you see her get off the plane for, and she's like 2.5 feet tall, and she's like being riding, and he's like freaks out. It is really, really funny.
It seems to be the highlight of the movie.
So it was
so it's not subtitled.
It's subtitled when they're speaking Korean, but it's mostly English.
Okay.
And it's when you see her 2.5 feet tall for the first time, you think he's joking, like he found something wrong with her. No, she's really 2.5 feet tall through the rest of the movie.
So what's your conclusion?
My conclusion to this movie is if you get that culture and you like to laugh and have fun, watch it. Definitely 5. If you don't have any idea about these weird overseas family values and arranged marriages and that type of thing, you're not going to get most of it. So I'm not quite sure why they're pushing for an American release. On that aspect, it gets like a 1 or a 2 because it is really funny when you understand what's going on, which is about a quarter of the movie. I don't understand the big push for America, but I'm glad they did because I got to watch something have a really funny, like I about fell out laughing when I saw she was 2.5 feet tall. I was like, what's going on? Definitely give it a shot if you understand that, but big warning, if you don't get the Korean culture and the family life, you're not going to understand it. At all. You'll be completely lost going, huh?
I didn't really like the movie.
Yeah. Huh. You're just that way.